Hola, y'all. Time for our next mile. It's almost 9 o'clock. We've been home for just a little while from an all-day basketball tournament in Vicksburg. Lots of games, lots of fun, lots of action. Good time with friends. Had some excellent ribs at a barbecue place. I mean, like, really good ribs. I love food. Overall, we just had a really long day, but great day. We had to wake up super early to drive over there, like a work day. But, excuse me. I didn't even know it was gonna rain, so we just had a nice little downpour. And I finally got a break away from some work on the blog, working on a recipe. And everybody's taking baths and getting settled, and I thought this is the perfect time to come outside, be alone. You'll have to excuse me. I have this awful dry cough, and it hasn't went away. So it's just annoying more than anything. I thought that today, for a few moments, I always talk about something that I feel. Sometimes I feel led to say it by the Lord. Sometimes I just want to talk about it because it's something that I'm dealing with, or something sparked a thought that day, or the moment I step out the door, and that's what I talk about. And right now, the only thing coming to my mind, the only thing that I feel, the only sentiment that I know to bring to you is contentment. Contentment. Yeah. Let's talk about it. There's a scripture. Is it godliness with contentment is great gain? I think it's something like that. Obviously, after I hit stop and I go inside and I grab my Bible, I'll check it out. The Bible talks about being content with what you have. We've talked about a little bit of thankfulness when I talked about the mile, about blessed. We've talked about balance, you know, putting priorities in the right place. This might seem like a super simple idea, a super simple concept, but I don't think it is as easy for us or for people as we might think. To be content, it's not necessarily happiness. I was gonna say to be happy with what you have. And yes, it is, but just, I don't know. I'm the Spanish word keeps coming to me. When I teach my students Spanish words for happy, so we have feliz, which is the expression for Feliz Navidad, Merry Christmas. So feliz is merry. You know, all is merry and bright. Merry Christmas. Merry. I'm trying to explain that word just by saying it over and over with my facial expressions and my voice. So, Merry Christmas. And then you have alegre, which is glad. Me alegre. I'm glad. And you know, there's a difference. There's a difference between gladness and merry, being merry. And then we have contento, which sounds like the English word content, and it even looks like it, but it ends in an O, contento. And to me, this is the happiness that comes from contentment, which is a place, I think, internally, a place of happiness that comes from being satisfied. I know, ooh, the taboo word of satisfied, because anytime you talk about satisfaction or being satisfied in the church, a lot of times you'll get a sermon in some way or a speech or about being lukewarm, or we should never be satisfied. We should always want more. We should always strive for more. And we should always desire to see God do more. We should desire blah, 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 blah. And yeah, those things are true in the correct context. Yes. But the Bible also says, and because we don't get to pick and choose what we want to believe or not believe in that book, we must take it all, which, by the way, is balance and temperance. I said godliness with contentment is great gain. And it is okay, and it is recommended, and it is commended by God to be content. And I'm not going to write you a book or talk forever about it, because it's just such a simple point. But I want to give you a couple of examples before I go. We should be content with what we have and find joy in the things that we have, realizing, this kind of dips into the blessed mile for a second, but realizing that the things that we have, other people don't have and wish they did, right? So it's wisdom to look and see what you have and say, it's good enough. It's good with me. It's okay. I'm okay with it. I'm thankful for it. I'm happy with it. I'm content. And it can go in so many different directions. I guess at the moment I'm thinking of material things, because that's where my mind goes immediately when I think of contentment. So I'll touch on that briefly. And then if my mind can wander into another category, I might mention that as well. I'm going to try to do this in just a few minutes. Sometimes I've ran into people like this, and it just seems like nothing's ever good enough. And by that, I mean, they don't say it necessarily with these words, but you can see it in the lifestyle. And it's actually really sad to watch, because they'll say, well, and again, they don't say it with these exact words. They say it with this language in a different way, but you can just watch. And it's like, we've always wanted this. If we can just have this, we'll be so happy. And they get it. And they work hard for it, and they get it, and they do it, and whatever. And it doesn't take very long before they say, I'm not happy with it anymore. I want something else. I'm not happy with this anymore. I want something else. Now, to avoid stepping into any type of controversial hot water, I think I'm going to go back to one of the Ten Commandments on this one. So hear me out. If you haven't just hit the button and turned me off, hopefully I haven't like deterred you from listening to this one. But just hear me out. You know, in the Ten Commandments, when you're not supposed to covet, which is desiring other people's things, whether it's their wife, yikes, or their husband, watch out. Or, I know we want to stop there, but what if it's their house or their car or their body, their clothes? What if it's their children? What if it's their reputation? What if it's their, you can fill in the blank. I think coveting is the opposite of contentment. So I wanted to bring that in because when I gave my example just a minute ago of people who said or gave off the assumption that this is what I've always wanted, this is what I want, and then when they get it, it's not long before they say, well, now I want this, or that's not good enough anymore, I want this, and I want this. It almost feels like this never-ending search for something to fill. So I'm not talking about people who've hit a milestone, and then they reach further for another goal. That's not what I'm talking about, so I wanted to make sure I clarified that. I'm talking about people who just never seem to be satisfied. They're never content. And I do think some of it comes from covetousness. Oh my word, I'm not even gonna try. I think that not being content can occur more frequently when you look around and you see what other people have or other people do, and you desire to have those things. And then you look back at your things and your things aren't good enough anymore. Maybe that's the best way that I could describe that. I'm trying to get that out. I actually heard a comedian a long time ago talk about a treat that this kid had received, a treat from his parents, and it was great. It was the best treat ever. Super content, super satisfied. Just love it. What could go wrong? Walking down the street to the store with his parents, he saw another child walk by with a treat that was similar to his, but much, much bigger and more colorful. And all of a sudden, this kid looked back at his treat that he's holding, and he's incredibly disappointed. And it's like, well, I don't want mine anymore. I want that one. Mine's not good enough anymore because I've seen that one. And I know this mile may not be popular. I get it. I just wanted to talk about it because the only feeling I feel right now is contentment. I'm very content today with my life. Are there things that need to be changed or my house needs improvements? Sure. But I love my house. God gave me this house when I was pregnant with my daughter and had my daughter and spoke to me and told me it was my house. So I had told someone, it will take the Lord speaking to me again to ever get me to get out of it. Like if we had an inclination to move or something, we would have to hear from God because I just can't leave something that God handpicked for me. I'm content. I need to paint my countertops. They're peeling. I painted them like 8 years ago or something and they're peeling. I need to paint that. I'm not happy with that because I need to fix it. But I'm not coveting other people's countertops. When I see other people's countertops, I think, man, that's really pretty. I probably couldn't afford that, But I love that. That's super pretty. It's beautiful. And I guess I don't think anything else about it. I just need to go paint my countertops because they're peeling. And they look terrible because they're peeling. The paint's peeling. Am I saying that I've never had a point in my life where I have desired something of somebody else's? Absolutely not. I am human. I am pretty sure there's been a point in my life where I've done that. I mean, I can't think of it off the top of my head, but I'm sure of it because I'm just a person. I'm like everybody else. So I'm not bringing this to you from a place of you people. Absolutely not. I guess I'm bringing this to you because I think it's very rare sometimes in life to feel this really good feeling of contentment. Because I have a tendency to always think I have to work more and do more and work harder and work longer and work stronger and faster against myself. My measure is against myself. My measuring stick. And I don't feel feelings of contentment very often because I think, well, Jesse, you could do this better than you did last week. You can make improvements here and you need to get to it. Like, time's a wasting. Do it. So, I had a really good day. Told you I was gonna keep this short. I am blabbering on and on and on. But if you're walking a mile with me, I'm trying to take up the mile and give you something to listen to. I had a good day watching my child play basketball. My children, both my children play basketball. My third did not play today. He played last night. I had a good day. I love watching my children play ball. I had some good ribs. I was with good friends. We had a safe 2-hour drive over there and back. Me and my husband laughed a lot, which we typically do every day. I'm content. And that bleeds into a feeling of thankfulness. Everything's good. It's calm. It's quiet. Everybody's happy. Everybody's healthy. Life is good. The last thing I want to say, and hopefully it's not a repeat of something I've already said, but I think what the scripture means that contentment is great gain is that if we're not content, then there is no calm. Contentment brings calm. And we're always like teetering on the edge of, you know, dissatisfaction brings a lot of movement, a lot of worry. It can bring a lot of stress, just a lot of snippiness. Because if you're constantly wanting more, you're putting pressure on the people around you. Because you're not happy. And your family feels it, and they see it. And if they're close to you and they love you, some of them will pitch in to try to satisfy you with the things that you seem to so desperately need to be happy. And then when it happens and it comes to fruition, and they think, thank goodness, this is it, they'll be happy now. And when we're not happy, we're depleting the people around us of the energy and the resources that they have invested because they love us to make us happy and to make us content. Some of us have people in our lives that are willing to go way out of the way to give us what it is they think we're searching for and to help us. And if that is constantly not enough, we run the risk of depleting the people that are in our lives and running them down, because if it constantly isn't enough and then there's another thing, hopefully not. But I do think some people give up. I've heard many expressions like, I quit because you're never satisfied. I quit because nothing makes you happy, so I can't help you anymore. And I'm not just talking about like, I wasn't just talking about like close relationships. I mean, that may be at work. That could be a colleague. a husband, a wife, a child, like, you know. So I am content today. I'm content with my miles with you. I'm content with my conversations with God. They have been beautiful and sweet. I'm content with my daily devotion reading. I'm loving all the stuff that I'm studying and writing down and trying to apply. I'm content with my family, my job, my church, like all the way around. And that is great gain. I hope you're content today. I really do. I do hope that you're able to look around in your life and say, it's enough. Because it is enough. Count my blessings one by one, your goodness in my